understand how the first ever honeybee vaccine works, I'm sure your appreciation for honeybees will boost even more. Nature has special ways to care for the young. It is beautiful. I was very interested from the very beginning in the science behind the new vaccines for honeybees. Well, who wasn't? The first vaccine for insects ever created. That by itself is so cool. I made a video about them in 2020 where I talked about the immune system of honeybees, but I didn't cover specifically how the vaccine might work. In the same way vaccines revolutionized both human and veterinary medicine, vaccines will also change the beekeeping industry. The honeybee colony, this social organism, has so many similarities with mammals. For example, did you know that royal jelly is the analog of milk in mammals? Yes, crazy, right? The superorganism produces special food for the newborns, just like mammals. Another example is thermoregulation. Did you know that honeybees are able to control their temperature like mammals? There are plenty of other examples, but I'm going to leave them for another video. The superorganism has so many similarities with mammals that it was clear that the colony must also have a way to immunize itself from previous infections and transfer that immunity to the next generation of bees. Otherwise, they wouldn't have a chance in nature. The ability to transfer immunity from one generation of insects to the next is called transgenerational immune priming, and researchers knew honeybees were able to do it for a while. The first demonstration of transgenerational immune priming in honeybees was recorded in 2014 by Dr. Javier Hernandez-Lopez in a publication in the Proceedings of the Royal Society B, where he demonstrated that the injection of American fowl brood bacteria and E. coli into the hemolymph of honeybee queens make the next generation of bees less susceptible to the infection by these pathogens. In this publication, it was clear that the infected honeybee colonies were less susceptible to the disease in generations ahead. Two problems though. One, the authors use injections in the honeybee queens, which makes the method very difficult to be used in real-life situations. The second problem was that nobody knew how the immune transfer occurs. The researchers didn't know the molecular basis of the process. It was 1 year later, in 2015, when Dr. Heli Salmela, working in collaboration with Dr. Dalio Freitag in Finland, published a scientific article describing the preliminary molecular model on how immunotransfer occurs in honeybees. It turns out that vitellogenine is the carrier of immune elicitors to the next generation of honeybees. Vitellogenine is the main component of the fat bodies of honeybees and an important multifunctional tissue used as well in the honeybee eggs. In another word, once a honeybee colony gets a bacterial infection, somehow pieces of this bacteria attach to the vitellogenine and end up in the fat bodies of the honeybee queen. And even more interesting, these pieces of bacteria are somehow transported to the ovaries of the honeybee queen. Isn't that amazing? The best part is that the whole vaccination process can be done orally, allowing Dalan Animal Health to use the natural biological defenses already in honeybees to develop the first ever honeybee vaccine. In the new vaccine, a concentrate of dead bacteria is mixed with the candy given to honeybee queens in honeybee operations to simulate the process mentioned earlier. Whoa, wait a minute, Humberto. How does this pieces of bacteria get into the queen if she doesn't feed herself? I know a bit of honeybee biology, and if I remember correctly, honeybee queens rarely feed themselves in the colony, and they are also better protected against diseases. Well, I'm glad you asked. Here is where the story gets even more fascinating. Yes, honeybee queens are fed by honeybee workers most of the time, which begs the question, how the queen will get the immunity to pass it to the next generation of bees without being sick herself or consuming the candy with the vaccine? To understand that, we need to look at the natural infection of honeybee colonies. Sick honeybee queens won't have the strength to lay healthy eggs. If the honeybee queen needs to get sick to pass the immunity, that would be too risky for the colony because the honeybee queen can die in the process. So how does evolution take care of that? Evolution has shaped a system where the queen doesn't need to be infected to transmit immunity to the young larvae. The key to the process is the worker bees. The worker bees are the ones dealing with sick brood all the time, making sure diseases don't spread throughout the whole colony, a process called hygienic behavior. Worker honeybees developed the ability to process bacterial material into small pieces that travel from the gut to the hypopharyngeal glands to produce royal jelly containing these little pieces of bacteria. The worker bees then share this special food with the queen, eliminating the risk to make the queen sick, at the same time giving the queen the ability to transmit these pieces of bacteria to the young generation, protecting them from potential infection. The same process applies to the vaccine. When Dalan Animal Health finishes the full development of the vaccine, the beekeeper will receive a solution of concentrated dead bacteria to be mixed with the sugar candy normally given to honeybee queens in beekeeping operations. The honeybee workers then consume the candy and feed the honeybee queen with the necessary information to be transmitted to the next generation of bees throughout the eggs. Now you understand how nature takes care of bees and how the Dalan Animal Health vaccine works. The immune system of honeybees is revealing itself to be much more complex than we could imagine in the past. If you want to have an overview about the immune system of honeybees, please watch this video right here.